Humans live to consume.
And their appetites are endless. They drop garbage on the ground wherever they go. Earth is like a house they've lit on fire but continue to live in. And they use Earth's resources to make ugly things like teal crocs and truck nuts.
Better living through television.
Okay, got the idea.
Oh, we're in fine spirits at the TV Tan Studios.
We are?
Well, I don't know. I've been in a fucking rock and roll recording studio all weekend.
Oh, that's why you're in such a good fucking mood.
Yeah, so, you know, what else would I be doing but spending the last part of the weekend that I haven't seen recording in a different studio?
Nice.
With you.
Oh, Lord, that was a weird sound I just made there. The tea kettle's on.
Oh. And by the way, who the fuck are you?
I be Tommy Milagro.
And I'm Bill Frost. This is TV Tan Podcast, episode 0397.
Yeah.
Right?
That is right.
Yeah, okay.
397 episodes.
All right.
Where people listen to us bullshit about what TV you really need to watch harder.
Man, we got a better scam going on than Anna Delvey.
Right?
Yeah.
And the funny part is, we're not charging anybody for this.
No. It's
yet.
Completely free to you, the consumer. Have you watched Inventing Anna on Netflix?
I have not because I don't have Netflix.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm in protest.
You're the one.
Yeah, I am protesting them hard.
Okay, well, you're going to bring them to their knees one day here.
Yes.
But anyway, Inventing Anna is based on the true story of Anna Delvey, a.k.a. Anna Sorokin, who defrauded banks and New York socialites and all sorts of people out of millions of dollars posing as a German heiress.
Oh.
And she was always just one step ahead of the law. And she finally got put in the jail, and Netflix paid her a bunch of money for her story, the rights to her story, about $230,000, I think.
How much?
About $230,000.
Okay. So yeah. More than our ever dwindling budget.
It's not going to make any kind of dent in her debts that she's got to pay off, but we'll, yeah. But it's an interesting story. The Anna Delvey is played by, I've already blanking on her name.
Hang on.
It's from Julia Garner from Ozark.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, I know who you're talking about.
Yeah,
now.
Julia Ooh. Garner from Ozark, and in this bizarre accent, which apparently is based on the real accent that Anna Delvey used. But who knows if that's even real, because little about her was real. And also, Anna Chlumsky plays a reporter for the fictional Manhattan Magazine.
And we've talked about that before.
Yeah.
And, oh, yeah, I'm seeing Julia Garner here. Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, it's a Shonda Rhimes production, so it's all sorts of glitzy, and she looks like she spent a shit ton of Netflix's money on this thing. So I'd recommend checking that out.
This feels to me like Catch Me If You Can.
A little bit,
but it's got a better cast.
Yeah, and also besides recommending that, I will recommend the Bohemian Brewery. Brewski,
the official sponsor of TV Tan Podcast.
This is the Mountain Lager.
Yeah.
Haven't had this one for a while.
Because we've been mostly sucking down cervezas.
And the Hefeweizen, but now we got a lager. It's a darker lager, but it's a little on the sweet side, but it's good stuff. And since it's going to snow here any second now.
We hope, we pray. We're asking you, Crom, deliver us snow.
Yeah.
That's how it works, right? We pray for snow and everything will be fine.
Fucking A, right. All right. So we got the beer. We got everything is in order here except for, my mental capacity is severely depleted, as I'm sure yours is, just because, you know, it's
me.
Being
yeah.
you. It's,
yeah.
It's a full-time job being you.
God, it is so much a hard job being
yeah,
me.
Yeah.
Not many people can deal with being me, especially since I have an MBA. Don't worry, this is not the sports thing, so you don't have to chug yet.
All right.
So
I got a few things coming up this week I want to tell you about.
Okay.
First of all, Law & Order Original Flavor was canceled about 12 years ago.
canceled, or did Dick Wolf just say, nah, I want to focus on SVU?
No, it wasn't Dick Wolf. Dick Wolf will produce anything, anytime, anywhere. Mm-hmm. He makes those shows.
Like, and they will churn out.
Yeah, yeah. He's got a whole fucking slate of Chicago shows. Now he's got a whole bunch of FBI shows.
Mostly just to give extras in New York and Chicago something to fucking do.
Yeah, Dick Wolf will not turn down anything. So, no. They just, NBC canceled it right on the verge of its, I think it was entering its 21st season.
Mm-hmm.
It was going to break the record for longest running drama on TV.
But no, they denied.
Fell just short of it, so SVU now holds that crown.
Okay.
Yeah. With 23, 24 seasons.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
So that is the official longest running show.
Yes, it is.
Okay.
And The Simpsons is the longest running cartoon. Mm-hmm. And It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia is the longest running live action comedy.
So I think we talked about this last time. Simpsons is on its 30
something.
Fuck.
30 something seasons. Yeah.
All right. And then It's Always Sunny is
going to be
15?
Going to be cracking its 15th season, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Wow.
I know.
It's like the
useless fucking facts. No one needs to know this shit, but I do.
But it's important for everybody to know that these are shows that you need to have in your life.
Sure, why not?
Yeah.
But Law and Order is back for the first time in 12 years on Thursday. So now you got a whole night of Law and Order. You got original flavor.
Sam Watterson.
Yep, Sam Watterson and Anthony Anderson returning.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Also, you got Law and Order SVU, and you got Organized Crime with Chris Maloney.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay. So a whole night of Law and Order just the way God intended it.
Now, my question is, I know Sam Watterson and his eyebrows will be acting hard.
Yes, they will.
And Anthony...
Anthony Anderson from Blackish.
And here's my question. Is he...
He was in the final season before it got canceled.
Okay. So, but my question was more, is he done with ABC at this point?
Oh, yeah. Blackish is almost over.
Oh, okay. So yeah. They're finally-ing their show.
Yep.
And Kenya Barris?
He's moved on to Netflix, much like everybody from ABC has.
Of course.
Yeah.
I would have thought he'd be more of a Hulu man, but no.
No, no.
Yeah. Netflix is where the money is at.
Yeah, he did that show Black AF. And I believe it's coming back for another season.
Okay.
Yeah.
So who's going to be the partner for Anthony Edwards, and who's going to be the plucky ADA for Sam Watterson?
You know, we're going to have to wait and find out. I did not get that information.
That's okay. I'll try to research that at this moment.
Yeah,
here.
See what you can pull up there, because God knows this is important information.
It is.
And also on Sunday, Killing Eve, the final season on BBC America, fourth and final season, fantastic series. Sandra Oh, Jodie Comer. If you have not availed yourself of Killing Eve, Hulu that shit.
Is it all on Hulu?
I believe it,
was like,
it is.
I want to say it's on like either Paramount or Showtime. I'm
pretty sure it's Hulu.
I'll double check on that later.
I'm just going to say sure. It's on fucking Hulu.
All right.
And yeah. And oh my God.
What?
Oh my God.
What is it?
A new Viking series?
Like a spinoff?
A spinoff, yeah. They did 6 seasons over on the History Channel.
Oh shit.
Yeah. And a lot of episodes. I mean, almost about 80-something episodes.
And overall. Bloody as fuck.
Yeah, and good old Edge.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was in there for a minute.
Yeah, flat nose.
Yeah, as if with everything, Netflix is at it again with Vikings Valhalla. This is set 100 years after the events of the original Viking series and follows the exploits of Leif Erikson.
Oh, okay.
Uh-huh.
They're going to try to get all historic on your ass.
Well, Vikings was allegedly historically accurate, but
yeah.
It was on the History Channel, so it's probably not. I mean, that's
never thought I'd say those words either.
I mean, come on, that's where Ancient Aliens is. Come on.
Yeah.
And Big Sky, this is a show that...
Somebody's watching?
A lot of people are watching this show, actually. Big Sky, you can catch it next day on Hulu. It returns on Thursday on ABC.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing about this show, ABC has been fucking it around so much on the schedule, you never know when it's on or when it's... We're off for a few months. We're back on for a month.
It's like they're trying to curb your enthusiasm with
that. Yes, yeah. So that's back on Thursday. I'd recommend that's also on Hulu. You can check that out. Amber Ruffin show is back on Peacock on Friday.
Okay.
The one of the only hits from the original hits from the Peacock network. Don't flock to the cock.
Are we done flocking to the cock?
There's some stuff on there worth watching, but for the most part, I would just try the free version because you can get the Amber Ruffin show with the free version
mm-hmm. Okay.
every week.
Yeah.
So try that. Yeah.
That's all you need right now.
And I saw some promos for this while I was watching the latest episode of Billions. Maybe me and Ted are the only ones sticking with Billions. I don't understand it. I don't understand the financial machinations. Maybe Ted does. I don't know.
Is that our erstwhile third host of the TV 10 podcast?
Yeah, if Ted can weigh in and tell me, one, if he's still watching Billions, even now that Axe is gone, and now we got the new guy in, the new Balder guy in.
Let me see if he's reached out to us via the Twitters.
And the second question I would like to know is, does he understand any of the finance talk on here?
Right, because we fucking don't.
No. And also, here's an interesting, it's on the Vice channel on the day this episode drops on Monday, the new docuseries called Devoured. And people love their food shows.
Mm-hmm.
They love their true crime shows.
Right.
What if you combined food and true crime into a single series? You're just printing money.
This feels like Gordon Ramsay, How I Started to Get Away with It, You Fucking Donkey.
Well, it's a bit of a long title, but that could work. This is called Devoured. It focuses on local cuisines in different cities and regions of the country, as well as the crimes that were attached to these things. Like, one of them was, the very first episode is about the Brooklyn Mafia going after someone who stole a secret recipe from a local pizzeria.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
I got another way to pair this up.
Cool. All right.
And you said the show was on...
Vice.
On Vice. Okay. So...
So in between the weed shows
mm-hmm.
and the other foodie shows and some the occasional alleged news show, now they have this.
Now, if you can shop over a special right in time with the second season of Yellow Jackets...
Mm, okay.
I think you have something to sell.
All right.
So what we're saying to the executive producers, you know, the CEOs over at Showtime, because I know you always listen hard to this podcast.
Mm-hmm.
Just cut us a check and we'll say thank you. That's all we ask.
Just hand over the money.
Yeah,
we'll take care of the rest.
Just give us the money.
Yeah,
yeah. We're like Joe Rogan, except not.
Not at all. No. And I'm gonna throw a classic at you. One Ooh. I've been catching up on. This is from Hulu a few years ago.
Okay.
And this reminds me, this also ties into Law and Order. Jeffrey Donovan. Burn Notice?
Yes. Yeah, okay.
He is Anthony Anderson's new partner. I just remembered this.
Oh, on okay.
New, on the new Law and Order.
I'm on board for
anyway,
this.
Anyway, Mr. Burn Notice, between the years of Burn Notice and appearing on one of the seasons of Fargo.
Mm-hmm. Second season.
Yeah, and the new upcoming Law and Order season. In between there, a couple of years ago, he did a series called Shut-Eye on Hulu.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Not, I remember this now.
It's a little bit of that Breaking Bad, Ozark kind of vibe to it, mm-hmm. to where he and his wife, they played fake fortune tellers,
mm-hmm.
and they were part of the gypsy circuit of fortune tellers, and they kind of had to pay out all their money to the local gypsy mob.
Mm, the gypsy mafia.
Yes. Yeah. They called the Romas.
Oh, the Romas.
Yeah, they don't like gypsy.
Oh, right, because that's such a... That's racist now.
Yes, it is. And so he's a sort of a failed magician, con man. They're both doing these fake readings for people, you know, mm-hmm. basically taking their money. And one day he gets in an accident and something happens to where he literally is now a psychic.
Oh, okay.
So the whole thing is twisted around. It's sort of a twisted crime drama with fortune tellers in the background in LA.
Mm-hmm.
And two seasons on Hulu. Worth checking out.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
I remember starting it when however many years ago it was on, and now I'm just finishing the second season after a long time off.
Okay.
Yeah.
And is it everything you hope for and more?
Yeah, it's pretty good. I don't know if there's going to be a definitive end to it because it was canceled after the second season. Mm. So maybe there's a cliffhanger. Maybe there's not. I don't know.
So I'll see Shut-Eye, and yeah. I'll raise you Pennyworth.
Pennyworth. Oh, yeah.
So I found out that it's on HBO Max. And
so they finally figured out that no one even knew what Epix was.
Right.
Yeah.
And
you know, it's on HBO Max. Okay.
I saw the second season and I have to say I had to pause and go, the fuck?
The fuck?
So I.
Yeah. For those of you who don't know, this is the origin story of Alfred.
Alfred Pennyworth.
Yes. Also known as Batman's gadget guy.
No. That's Lucius Fox. He was the gadget guy. He was the butler. So no, Alfred Pennyworth is very much a mod, if you will.
Okay.
And of course, he's trying to out Michael Caine mm-hmm. in this particular little spin-off here, this little spot of bother. But yeah, the first season was pretty awesome, but then the second season involves machinations with the Raven Society.
The Raven Society?
The Raven Society.
This is some Harry Potter shit? What's going on?
I'm trying to figure it out, too. So the Raven Society is trying to take over a jolly good old England and take over Parliament and Her Majesty, the Queen.
Right.
Oh, and by the way, the Queen's got COVID. So any day now, and we send our thoughts and prayers. Not yet. It's too early for that. but the second season got into some weirder, I want to say it was like all the old spy tropes of the 60s just mashed into one.
All right.
I can't make heads or tails. How they're going to do a third season is beyond fucking me.
Okay.
But otherwise, it's just interesting to see Jack Bannon, who plays Alfred Pennyworth, try to act off as if he was Michael Caine and try to figure out what he's going to do with that widow's peak he's got in the middle of his head there. It's like he's trying to part the sea, if you will.
Yeah.
So.
And we talk about Peacemaker a lot on this show, but I don't think we had the news last week so that we could report that season 2 will be happening.
Yep.
And we had some very special DC Universe cameos in the season finale on Thursday.
Yes, and I have to say, and here's the other thing. I think I sent this out on the Twitters the other day, or retweeted it, but the last episode of Peacemaker, not Peacewalker, I learned my lesson, apparently it was watched 44% more than anything else on HBO Max. Hence,
even Euphoria?
Right?
Huh?
I know.
Okay.
But maybe it was because of the cameos of, can we say at this point, or do we want
to? I don't want to spoil it.
All right. Either way, it is very telling that Cena is working so well with the DC Universe, and more importantly, DC and Warner Media have pretty much given James Gunn carte blanche to play with the characters.
But have you seen there's a beef going on between Stephen Amell and John Cena? Is that coming up in the sports
news? That is coming up in the sports news. I'm pulling it up here as we speak.
Phrasing.
Boom. I am very happy for what's going to be taking place here. So, what other... what other shows should the good people be watching?
Well, I did want to mention Euphoria. I don't have to tell people to watch Euphoria because they already are.
Mm-hmm.
And the record-breaking thing about that show is that it's an HBO original show mm-hmm. that goes to HBO Max. It's not a Max original that just stays there.
Right.
So, but I think it was about 85% of its viewership comes from HBO Max, not HBO cable.
Oh, satellites. Not HBO proper.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Hmm. So that tells you it's young folks who don't believe in cable or satellite TV.
They cut the cord.
They cut the shit out of that cord, and so this will continue the decline of America as prophesized by our parental TV council, whatever the fuck they're called.
So not learning about critical race theory, not learning about things of history, cutting music programs, cutting the arts, this is what's going to bring people down.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, the teens having sex and drugs on HBO.
Right.
Is going to destroy the country, tear the very fabric of the country apart.
Right. Between that and drill rap, which I learned was actually a thing.
Drill rap.
Yeah, it's amazing what you learn on The Daily Show with Trevor Noah. Drill rap is a thing.
Drill rap, okay.
Yeah.
Hmm.
And
I'm almost intrigued enough to look it up.
Almost?
Almost.
Maybe once it makes its way to Euphoria, that's when you'll say, oh yeah, now, Milagro told me about
Euphoria
this.
Euphoria is just playing 90s hip-hop jams. I don't know who the music director is on that show.
And that's a bad thing because...
Well, the teens are listening to that shit. Unless they're doing it ironically.
I'm going to say yes to both.
Okay.
But now if you can combine that with Yellow Jacket's 90s soundtrack.
And also, Food and Murder. We put all those things together.
And
teen sex and drugs, drill rap, food, and true crime.
Right.
If we can get all those into a single show, fuck, if we could get that into a single podcast.
Oh, yeah. That could be our spinoff.
We could get an exclusive deal, not with Spotify, maybe with a Deezer. We could make this a Deezer exclusive podcast for the right amount of money,
and
which would be any money.
Now, if that could be also narrated with Deezus, hey,
fuck, we're going down something here.
We are going down the pothole, folks.
Yeah,
it is coming down hard.
Yeah, and if we could also get our podcast on vinyl,
because it's a warmer sound.
It just sounds warmer, man.
Yeah, just all our greatest hits. Spinning on your turntable at 33 RPMs, or is it 45? Which is better?
You know, I believe the slower speeds are supposed to be better.
Oh, yeah.
But I don't know.
Maybe
because
on
because I haven't owned a record for 40 years, probably.
Oh, okay. So you're that one that wants to stay modern and go with the digital flow here.
I'm just saying. Since we've been in a rock and roll recording studio all goddamn weekend... with Magda Vega,
right?
There's the dissent in the camps that some people want no physical product whatsoever. Just put it all online, all the streaming and all the Bandcamp and all that shit.
Right.
Other people say, well, we should maybe make some CDs too. Mm-hmm. Where other parts of the camp, Robin, wants to make a bunch of vinyl records.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know how much it costs to make vinyl records?
I would say a metric fuck ton.
We'd have to sell them for about $30 a pop.
$30?
To make our money back.
Motherfucker.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I don't know if any of our fans have $30 because they can't pay a fucking cover charge to get into a bar. So are they going to give us $30 for a record?
We've seen our fans. So
mm-hmm. Yeah.
I will say... maybe half of the dozen can do it. And so I know
they might be employed or at least collecting unemployment.
I know how to help this out. Okay. I know a way this can be done.
Can you settle this argument?
Easily. Okay. And I'm going to use our good friend Spock from the band Way.
Oh, yeah.
So
he's got a garage full of those things.
Exactly. But here's the thing. So he had the album, but then he also included... a code.
Oh, yeah, download code, yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
So then you just do a few of those records, have that code in there, boom.
So we sell the records for about $50 a pop.
Right, because it'll be a collector's item.
Sure.
And, you know, press it with gold.
So I foresee my own garage filled with vinyl records in the future.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and then you go on tour... on Main Street or State, whichever is the more populous.
We are frequently touring Main Street and State Street and also Washington Boulevard in Ogden.
Right.
Yeah. So.
Yeah. Oh, and if you haven't figured out a title, Exile on Main and State Street.
Exile on both Main and... Okay. That works.
Just pitching it out there.
Yeah. Just for you non-fans out there, we tend to play a lot at bars on State Street.
Right.
Yeah.
Like God intended.
Yeah. And Main Street.
Yes. And what you're seeing right now is just how the process works in the background here. You got an inside look. This is behind the music.
Yeah, this is behind the music. Yeah.
Behind the anus of the music. Which, okay, there we go.
Behind the anus of the music.
Or man, behind the taint of the music.
That's even better. You know, most of these episode titles, I'm surprised they're making their way onto Apple Podcasts. They're just like,
I'm surprised we have not been banned yet.
So filthy.
Oh, Jesus.
And Apple Podcast is the most censor happy of all the platforms.
Oh, this is beautiful.
Say what you will about Spotify. They don't censor our episode titles.
Of course not. Look at what Joe Rogan's got putting on there. We're okay. But Apple Music? Hey.
Yeah. So anyway, yeah, I think you know what time it is.
I think it's time for you to hit the music.
And sports with Tommy Milagro. Go team.
From the sports desk of the TV 10 podcast, we deliver to you only the sport of professional wrestling. Before we get into the nuts and bolts, we do need to recognize this piece here. So we're going to be a bit somber here. Over last week, David Olson, which fans at the radio station X96 know as Punk, had recently passed away. Now, I'm bringing it up because
I'm curious about Punk's wrestling connection. I must be unaware of this.
Well, here's, and this is the story, and I've been meaning to do this. This is probably the best way I can do it right now. Now, Punk used to talk about his bad movie reviews and do a junk food update.
Yeah, it's pairings.
Yeah. And it was, you know, honestly, it was one of my favorite things to listen to on the morning zoo. Now, on this particular day, I'm working at the radio station. I just lost my regular job, and Punk...
Which is the only reason you would be working at a radio station.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And Punk and I were talking for a little bit. I told him where I was at, and he hands me this copy of this movie that he reviewed, WrestleManiac.
What?
Okay.
Okay.
So do you, I'm going to do.
I'm not familiar with this one.
All right. Let me do WrestleManiac. I'm going to do this exactly as it's written. We'll try to keep it tight here. WrestleManiac. That's right. Let the face-off begin. And and he writes about who's in the movie in here. But one of the names here is Rey Mysterio. This is senior. This is not junior, okay.
All right.
By the way.
All right.
He's El Mascarado, the government Olympic experiment gone wrong.
Okay.
Let's see. There are some other names. Nobody's going to know this. But
what year did this come out?
Let's see. According to this, this was written in 2008. So I'm assuming it came out around that time.
I know.
But I'm going to read the synopsis Punk wrote. When a van full of hot girls, drunks, and stoners decide to grab their home video camera and go to Mexico to film a porno, all seems well. But when a wrong turn and a need for gas leads into the middle of nowhere, despite warnings from the local roadside crazies, they end up broke down the legendary town of La Sangre de Dios, where the government has banished the deranged luchador El Mascarado. So with the night closing and the clothes coming off, the ultimate death match is about to be unleashed. Unless one of the hapless hippies can step up and remove the killer wrestler's mask before he removes their faces and adds them to her collection.
Man. 2006.
Okay, so it was a couple of years.
Was the release date of this
movie. Oh, yeah.
That's fantastic.
You want me to give the rating here?
Yes, please.
So at the time, Punk gives us two Prozacs and some Medrol for a command center, the Voorhees building, getting your shirt wet and losing your pants, going top rope, contortionist hiding brought to you by the letter M, the fast walking escape, getting keyed, mariachi fight music.
Really?
The porno mystery machine band. Wow. And yes, El Mascarado in the kitchen with a lead pipe.
Wow. So this is not available to stream anywhere on your services.
I already checked.
Yeah,
no.
You can buy it.
You can rent it on Prime Video. If you want to learn more about this and other great movies.
And why wouldn't you?
You need to go to punksmovies.livejournal.com. Also, back to the somberness, Obviously, his family has some expenses, not only for his funeral costs, but also for his various medical expenses. As soon as this episode drops, we're going to be putting the link to the GoFundMe page so that you can help out the Olsen family in this time of need here. Now, back to our regularly scheduled program, and that is the Wrestle.
Yeah, there's a few clips and trailers for WrestleManiac on YouTube.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is all sorts of awful here, but it's my favorite.
Man, just from the thumbnails alone. Wow. Okay.
The next time I'm over here, I'll be sure to bring it over. But over the weekend, Impact Wrestling, still a thing, still hard to kill.
Still happening.
They have.
Are they still on a network?
Yeah.
Are they still on Access?
They are still on Access.
Okay.
And they have their No Surrender pay-per-view. And as reported at Slam Wrestling's own Bob Kapoor, pretty big to-do happened. So right now, Red Badge of Courage Wrestling, mm-hmm. their wrestlers don't have a promotion yet.
Okay.
So they've been invading Impact Wrestling, so they are part of Honor No More. See how clever that was?
Yeah.
And apparently, and I'm going to read this from Bob Kapoor. Why, Eddie? Why? That's the question Eddie Edwards will have to answer after his actions during the main event of Impact Wrestling's No Surrender special event on Saturday night. Specifically, why did he turn his back on the company and help the renegade ROH faction Honor No More win the match and as a result, the right to stay in Impact? So, yeah, he did some naughty stuff, Eddie Edwards, and
all right.
Which is interesting because Eddie Edwards originally came from Ring of Honor, so there may be some backstory involved. I think you need to watch Impact Wrestling just a little bit harder, just to see what took place. And WWE, they had the Elimination Chamber, so
uh-huh.
that happened on the Peacock, and yet. Another reason not to flock to the cock. this actually happened. For those wondering, now this is in our news and rumors section at SlamWrestling.net. For those wondering the reason why Bobby Lashley was written out of the Elimination Chamber match, it's because he has a shoulder injury. Word is he's getting evaluated, and it happened during his match with Brock Lesnar at the Royal Rumble, so... but here's where it gets real interesting. The crowd for Elimination Chamber ended up being about anywhere between 15,000 to 20,000 people.
All right.
So, you know, compare that to either 45 or 50. Now, say that could be COVID. But wait, that's not a thing anymore, right?
Totally over.
It's totally over.
Totally over.
Yeah. Now, here's the other interesting thing.
So you're saying the numbers are down?
Just a titch.
So I'm going to say probably still more people than watch the Olympics.
Or listen to our podcast. So, yes.
I'll bet we have more listeners than there are Olympic viewers. Ratings were...
Yes!
Literally in the Elimination Chamber.
Right.
Flush this season.
Suck it, curling. This is the show to be on here.
Yeah.
Anyway, but the other thing is Brock Spott at the Chamber show where he smashed through the door of his pod was ad-libbed by Lesnar himself and was not part of the script. So, yeah, he actually smashed through a door on his own.
Hmm.
And that's serious plexiglass set in metal hinges.
Ooh.
Do you have any idea how fucking strong you have to be to get through that? Yes.
Yeah.
So, as for Elimination Chamber or No Surrender, check it out at SlamWrestling.net. That's where I write, you know, because I also have an MBA. Drink.
Is that a requirement at Slam Wrestling to have an MBA?
No, but it helps, and it gives you a reason to drink harder.
Well, you know, if you're an American.
Well, yeah, but thankfully we got Canadian listeners. Or, I think. Do we have Canadian listeners? Man. Somebody chime in.
Yeah, we'll get the analytics team on that.
Yeah,
straight away.
We will have that coming up here. But finally, this, as we mentioned earlier in the show, John Cena's Peacemaker is going to have a second season. And this is the best part. Now, he Now, for this is based off of a scene from Peacemaker. I'm just going to read this out here. So this is the exchange between Vigilante and Peacemaker asking if he's like Green Arrow. And there's Peacemaker going, no, not like Green Arrow. That dude goes to brony conventions. He's dressed like the back half of Twilight Sparkle with a four-inch wide butthole drilled in the costume. Somebody on Twitter wrote, I have no idea if Stephen Amell watches Peacemaker, but would genuinely love to hear what he thinks of the DCEU's first name drop of Green Arrow. To which, to Stephen Amell's credit, he replied back, haven't seen it. Too busy showing Cena what professional wrestling should really look like on TV. Wow. Referencing his heel show. Wow. So,
okay.
Can we just say there could be a collision of worlds?
Do you smell that? You burnt.
Oh, but know that there is more of this coming their way because it's sports.
All right, cool.
It's sports with Tommy Milagro. Go team.
Started sad, but then you stuck with it to the end.
Well, that's the fast forward button going.
Nobody heard that. They didn't hear that music, Ben.
No. So I want to tell y'all, if you're not watching Resident Alien on Sci-Fi.
Okay.
Yeah, I believe the first season is on the Peacock, or maybe it's Hulu.
We got to flock to the cock on this one?
Maybe for that one, yeah. Okay. The first season. The second season is currently on the Sci-Fi channel, and it's fucking fantastic. Alan Tudyk is a national treasure.
Yep.
And you should be watching it harder.
That's our only stipulation at this point.
Yeah.
Watch it harder. We ask so little of you. But I am going to also ask our fans to watch harder A Marvelous Mrs. Maisel.
Oh, yeah. New season started on Friday.
Yep. Two episodes are already there.
Yeah, that's the thing. Prime Video's previous seasons, they dropped all 10 to 8 episodes at once. Now they're like, oh, no, we're going to drizzle them out week to week. So you got to hang around.
Yeah, and actually we gotta save that money.
We got to keep that subscription rolling.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I'm on board for it, so I've got no problems with it whatsoever. I am also going to say Righteous Gemstones.
Yes, on HBO and HBO Max.
And when is the season finally going to end?
I think it's pretty soon. I think it's a short season. I think it's only like 8 episodes.
So as we're recording this...
Not tonight, maybe next week.
Okay, so this is penultimate.
Within the next couple weeks.
Okay.
This current season will be over.
Yeah. But the Dixie Mafia and Eric Roberts.
Psycho Ninjas.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, Neon Cycle Ninjas.
Oh, Neons. That's true. Yes.
Because that's the only way that they know that they're coming for you.
You don't want to confuse them with other Cycle Ninjas.
Right. And of course, you're trying to, you've been trying to badmouth them, and this is what happened here. But you did that yourself. No, you said it from your words. I was just speaking in those words. So don't fucking confuse things. God, that is so well written. That family.
Definitely so. Another one I will urge you again to check out, The After Party on Apple TV Plus. Mm-hmm. Very funny.
Yep.
Lots of goddamn funny people in that one.
But is John Hamm involved?
No, John Hamm.
No John Hamm. We're going to keep on the Hamm sighting as long as possible. So just stay tuned.
Is Hamm Watch?
Hamm Watch, yes.
Okay. All right.
Oh, sorry. It's Hamm Watch.
Hamm.
Two M's.
Two M's. Yeah. Okay.
Let's see. What other shows? Because mine, Book of Boba Fett ended. And
Book of, yeah, that one's over. I think it almost redeemed itself in the end.
Yeah.
For the most part.
Because of Rancor. Riding a Rancor. Yeah. How nobody can get psyched up for that, I don't understand. I blame your souls for being so calloused.
I concur.
Yeah.
I concur with that, definitely.
Let's see. We already talked about Mrs. Maisel. What else? Superman and Lois. Hopefully it'll be coming back. I noticed they haven't dropped a new episode in a while.
Yeah, I think it will be back.
Okay. But what other shows?
Keep riffing. I got to look this up.
Well, I'm trying to think of anything else to watch a little harder. I would say, oh, definitely have fun at Tubi because they got some great kung fu shows, I found out the other day. So they got the Wu-Tang Kickoff. And
Tubi has got so much shit on there.
Right?
Yeah.
It is a wonderful thing. They got the Street Fighter on there. Return of the Street Fighter. Sister Street Fighter.
Hmm.
And that was the terriblest one of the Street Fighter series.
The terriblest, okay.
Yeah.
All right.
It's a word.
Yeah.
As far as anybody knows, that's very cromulent.
Yeah. The one I wanted to recommend to you check out, the first three seasons of Killing Eve are available on Hulu.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
All right.
So I would definitely recommend. They're about 8 to 10 episodes apiece. I would highly recommend that. And also wanted to, you should check out the, if you stayed away
mm-hmm.
out of, you know, what became of the series during its first run, Dexter New Blood.
Yeah.
Very good. A decent reset of the series. So now that it's all over, you can, you know, if you have the Showtime, you can watch it. And once again, bringing up Robin because that's the only way she will listen if I drop her name. And if you are a listener and you want us to stay in your good graces and you want us to mention your name on the show here, if that's the only way to keep you listening, fine, we can do it.
Yeah. Oh, and the sports page.
It's like a reverse Patreon or something.
Yeah. that'll be our title next week. Reverse Patreon,
but... double reverse Patreon. Yeah, yeah. The only gripe I and Robin had with this thing, she finally just finished the first season there.
Okay,
season was fine.
Mm-hmm.
It's about ten episodes, I think.
Yeah, 10.
Nice story wrapped up nicely.
Mm-hmm.
It's probably no going forward after this.
Well, unless you involve Dexter's son in some way, but then...
A serial killer series called Harrison has no ring to it.
Right.
Yeah.
So maybe they could do Dexter Harrison's plight?
Well, no colon extra titles.
Right.
Because the one gripe both of us had was that, and I didn't even think about it until she mentioned it, the title card,
mm-hmm.
Dexter... New Blood. It's like unnecessary.
Oh, okay.
Unnecessary sound effects and overall bullshit.
I didn't even know about that. Now
you're thinking
about
it. Yeah.
I'm trying to go back and go, was there? Maybe there was.
Yeah.
I did know it got bloodier and bloodier with each episode.
Annoying title cards.
Yeah.
With sound effects. Don't do that.
Unless it's Invincible and when it gets bloodier and bloodier, then it's awesome.
Yeah, okay.
There is an exception okay, to
that
a
one,
rule.
That one works, but the Dexter New Blood, no, fuck that. Don't do that. If there is another season of New Blood, don't do that.
Yeah. Just
there
just
won't be.
Just
there
not.
Can't be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But if there's a Yellow Jackets where Dexter gets involved, hey.
Man, you keep coming back to the Yellow Jackets.
I'm really that into that show. It's like a cannibalistic Lost.
Yeah.
So
well, we don't know if Lost was not cannibalistic.
Well, J.J. Abrams didn't go down that hole, so...
Would have been a better show.
Right?
I know.
But, of course, ABC is all about family.
Yeah, so also, I'm going to encourage you all to go, in Punk's honor, go buy or rent WrestleManiac.
Yes.
On whatever, wherever you get your video-on-demand movies.
Maybe, you know what I was thinking about the other day? Because he wrote... Very extensively. I want to see if any of the shows that he ever reviewed probably found its way to like Tubi or Pluto or...
Some of them must have.
I checked WrestleManiac. It's not there for whatever fucking ungodly reason. But the rest? Oh,
they could be out there.
They have to be out there. So, and that's punksmovies.livejournal.com.
Live journal, still live. Cool.
Yeah,
okay.
I can't believe it's still a thing. But yeah.
And again, I know some people are still using Blogspot.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. So,
like that's... the Utah beer blog.
Oh, that really?
I know that guy, Mike Riddell. Yeah. I think it was about 10 to 15 years ago. He's talking about. Yeah, I'm thinking about switching platforms. Never has.
honestly, you're not missing much on the platforms or the social medias. You're probably is he happy? Would you say?
Well, he's got a job basically drinking beer. So yeah.
Don't go to Twitter. Don't go to Facebook. Don't go to Instagram.
Just go straight to TikTok.
No, not even fucking TikTok. Fuck TikTok.
All right, so you're thinking, what, Google Buzz?
Not even that.
Okay.
Maybe at the very least, just Apple Music, and then he can listen to our podcast, and everybody's happy.
You know, he doesn't have a podcast.
Oh, he doesn't?
No.
Oh.
Maybe we should have him on.
Yes.
The next time we have some Bohemian.
Some Bohemian?
Bohemian.
Wow.
Become cool whip.
Why are you, you're saying it weird. Why are you putting so much emphasis on the H?
Cool whip. Cool whip.
Say whip.
Whip.
Now say cool whip.
Cool whip.
Cool whip.
Cool whip.
Cool whip.
Oh, God. Well, if we haven't lost you now, we want to say thank you to our sponsor this week, Bohemian Brewery and the Brewski Mountain Lager.
Yes.
Celebrate the snow if it's here by the time you download this.
And again, thank you for sticking through that Seth MacFarlane secondary show there.
I don't know what the fuck was going on there.
It was going somewhere.
But also our other fine sponsors.
Why, that would be our sponsors, Sugar House Distillery. Then there's Outlaw Distillery. And don't forget, there's Ogden's Own Distillery, the fine purveyors of Five Wives Vodka, Five Husbands Vodka. And yes, they're the same thing, but that's okay. Use the pronouns correctly.
Yeah.
Madame Paterini Gin. Then there's the Porter's Fire, the Porter's Peanut Butter Whiskey. Then there's the... there's also the cans. There's the... what do we have left again? Vodka?
Got some whiskey cola.
That's it.
Whiskey and cola in tiny cans. Mm-hmm. Also, there's a gin and tonic in Madame Paterini, gin and tonic in cans, and there's a few others.
And, of course, you can always go to Boozteak and just pour out any of these drinks into some lovely glassware or...
Probably not on premises.
Not yet, anyway. or you could just get some stuff to mix up your own little fine drink. But no matter where you go, say TV Tam Podcast sent you. And for right now, wear a mask. Yeah, we're not over with it. The Utah legislature said it was over? No, it's not. Fucking stop listening to them.
Yeah, reach out to us. TV Tam Podcast, Twitter, Facebook, Gmail, all TV Tam Podcast. Send us whatever the fuck you want.
Yeah, write to us.
We'll take dick pics. Really? Tommy will take dick pics.
No. I'm not going Dick's Ahoy again. All right?
Okay.
I'm not going Dick's Ahoy.
Tommy Malagro welcomes your dick pics.
Do I have to say Cox Ahoy every time? Is that the deal?
Yes. Every time your email loads up, ding, Cox Ahoy.
Oh, I can't wait to see that email, which is at tvtampodcast@gmail.com.
Yeah. So on that note... Good night, America.
And jiggle that handle and, oh yes, you. Off you fuck.
What are you doing?
Watching the game. When these hammy humans are finished, I'm going to pick the celestial flowers that grew from the water of my spaceship. It is for my radio.
What do flowers have to do with your radio?
Plants have the most complex biochemistry of anything in nature. And humans give them to say, I love you. Here are some flowers. You are dead.